We have expressed in no uncertain terms here at the United Nations through a very strongly worded press statement from the Security Council.
I'm sorry, but the UN must be firm with you. Let me see your whole palace or else.
Or else what?
Or else we will be very, very angry with you. And we will write you a letter telling you how angry we are.
And we have expressed in no uncertain terms here at the United Nations through a very strongly worded press statement from the Security Council that we expect the Taliban to respect human rights, including the rights of women and girls.
So would you believe in the democratic vote, though? So would people be allowed to vote in women politicians?
The Taliban says they want Sharia. Well, the entire Muslim world supports them in that. Pew polls demonstrate that hundreds of millions of Muslims want Sharia. The Muslim Brotherhood's own bylaws say that the very reason they were established were to establish Allah's law in the land. Sharia, Allah's divine law. The largest voting bloc in the United Nations, the OIC, the Organization of Islamic Cooperation, 57 members. That's every Muslim nation on earth, plus something they call the Palestinian territories, says they want Sharia. In 1990, they approved, and in 1993, they serve to the United Nations the Cairo Declaration on Human Rights and Islam, which says life can only be taken away for a Sharia-prescribed reason. There is no crime or punishment except as provided by Sharia. And the last two articles in the Cairo Declaration on Human Rights and Islam that has been published for the world to see and served to the United Nations as an official document says all rights and freedoms stipulated in this declaration are subject to Islamic Sharia. And finally, Islamic Sharia is the only source of reference for the explanation or clarification of any articles of this declaration, which is the Declaration on Human Rights and Islam, approved by the entire Muslim world, which means at a geopolitical level, every Muslim nation on earth has the same objective as Al-Qaeda, ISIS, the Taliban, and the Muslim Brotherhood.
Would that still include women's rights and a democracy? So would you believe in the democratic vote, though? So would people be allowed to vote in women politicians?
Chanting death to America, but they seem friendly at the same time. It's utterly bizarre.